Good morning, church. How are you all doing? We just want to bless you today. Today, you may notice there's a new slide. It says planted for relationship. You know, our theme this year has been planted, almost like we're planted in God's garden. And there's four emphases. Right now, we want to really believe God is calling us to relationship, caring for one another, whether it's at home in our families. It can be hard. We're always seeing each other. Maybe it's virtually with your workplace, your coworkers, or at school, right? You got to see people. But today, God really says to us, we're planted for relationship. You look at that picture. It's a picture of these really nice, beautiful, I don't know if it's grapes or blueberries, but Jesus says, I am the vine and you are the branches. So we are the branches. We are all of those beautiful fruits. Some are more ripe than the others. Some are more dry than others. Maybe you feel that way. You're that dry fruit right now. But today Jesus says he's in our midst. And when we are planted in him, in relationship with him, in relationship with one another, he will give us life. So let's declare that today. Let's pray. Father God, we declare that in you is life. We declare that we are planted in you because when we go into the unknown territory and season right now, you will guide the way. So help us to meditate on your word day and night. Help us to hear you speak, Lord, because you're here in our midst, leading us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you, I worship you.
You are here, mending every heart.
You are here, mending every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
You are.
You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 are. That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are.
Even
when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. Never stop, you never stop working. Never stop, you never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
So Lord, we just declare that you are the waymaker. In our workplaces, in our homes, in our schools. Lord, you are the one who makes the way. So we are planted in you, Lord, because you make the way for us to find life. We praise you, Jesus.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 Who you are.
We declare it, Lord.
That is who you are. That is who you are.
Declare it over our homes.
That is who you are.
So we welcome Jesus into our homes now because he is here. That's who he is. He's in our midst moving. So welcome, church. If you are just tuning in to our Facebook stream, we welcome you with God's peace because Jesus said, my peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I did not give to you as the world gives. So let's give a high five or a handshake. Or I guess if you're at home with family, give them a hug or we give an L bump. Peace with you, Josh. So Jesus' peace is with us wherever we go because of the Holy Spirit. How wonderful. So just for a few announcements now, you've probably been seeing this for a few weeks. We've been hosting kind of the sharing table, which is basically just a time after the service to call each other, and we just share praise reports of what God has been doing. Last week, a few people were just sharing about how God had called them to give generously to make bread and just drop it off at their friends and relatives' houses while keeping distance. But it's just a time to encourage one another. So if you're able to, we'd love to hear from you so we can just share encouragement and pray together. And the meeting link will be shared with you. Youth groups has been continuing with virtual hangouts. I know on Friday was the first time we kind of had a virtual Bible study, and we're still learning how to make it more interactive. And there's been lots of different creative ways of how to do that. And the other group is that the Monday groups too. Or maybe I'm in the wrong order because I think after youth group, it's youth homework hangout on Wednesdays, 3 to 4. So if you have any homework you need help with or you just want a space to be together to motivate one another, come on. If you have homework questions, send it in advance to your youth leaders so they can help you out with math or whatever it may be. And then our university and career groups are continual meeting online on Monday, 7:30 with Vance, and Friday at 7:30 with Gary. I know, yeah, just on Friday, there was a Netflix party, so that's a lot of fun to watch and comment on movies together. Now, let's read together our offering and our offering verse from Malachi, which really just declares how faithful God is. These are not easy times. These are turbulent times. But the people of Israel also faced turbulent times, and so they would declare their faithfulness to the Lord, that the Lord is the one who provides. So let's read this together. Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that there will not be room enough to store it.
Malachi 3, verse 10.
Let us continue to worship. That Christ is enough. Christ is our reward. We can trust Him.
Christ is my reward and all of my devotion. Now there's nothing in this world that could ever satisfy. Through every trial, my soul will sing, no turning back. I've been set free. Christ is enough for me. Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in You. Everything I need. Christ, my all in all, the joy of my salvation. And this hope will never fail. Heaven is our home. Through every storm, my soul will sing, Jesus is here. To God be the glory. Christ is enough for me. Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in You. Everything I need. Christ is enough. Christ is enough for me. Christ is enough for me. Everything I need is in You. Everything I need.
I have decided.
I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me. No turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back, no turning back, no turning back.
So Jesus, we declare our allegiance in you, that there is no turning back now because we see you are before us. The cross is before us. Lord, so give us faith to follow you into the unknown territory. Give us faith to follow you, Jesus, so we will not turn back but turn to the cross and run to where you lead us to run. We commit this offering to you. We thank you, Lord Jesus. And now let's pray together the offering prayer. All things come from you, God, and of your own do we give you. Amen. Now let's recite together the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. Now we will have the reading of the Gospel.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the mark of the nails, and place my finger into the mark of the nails, and place my hand into his side, I will never believe." 8 days later, his disciples were inside again, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and put out your hand and place it in my side. Do not disbelieve, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Amen. May we have the faith to see Jesus. Now we're going to do something new and exciting. We have just passed through Easter, and now we're entering into a new season, a new sermon series called Into the Unknown. Maybe that's how we feel right now. We're going into the unknown territory with this virus, but we place our faith in Jesus. So now we're going to play for you a music lyric video that we have created. Enjoy.
Into the unknown, into the unknown, into the unknown. But I won't stay at home.
There's a thousand shows I wanna watch online, and ignore your whispers, though you're looking all the time. Oh, oh. Shops aren't open, some people have lost their careers. Coronavirus, COVID-19, it's not the end, don't you fear. Wash your hands and stay at home to work and eat and pray. I'm listening, Holy Spirit, so I'm open to what you say. I need your strength inside me. I need you to see me through. I'm afraid, so Jesus, give me faith to follow you into the unknown. Into the unknown. Into the unknown. How will you lead me? 'Cause I don't know what steps to take. Are you here right beside me in case I make a big mistake? You say be strong and courageous to overcome the fears. Obey the Lord and read his word so you know he's near. Every day's a little harder as I see the virus grow. But Jesus is victorious, so with him I'll go. Into the unknown. Into the unknown.
I hope you enjoyed that stirring rendition of the COVID-19 Into the Unknown. So this is our series as we begin into the book of Joshua. We're titling it Into the Unknown. We think it really fits with our current context. If you haven't seen Frozen 2, go ahead and watch it. Go watch it. My kids really enjoy it. I had already been listening to this song very many times, and then I had to listen to myself singing it many times. But we're going to follow this book of Joshua, and we're going to follow the story of God leading his people with Joshua as their leader into the unknown of the future, into the unknown of the promised land that their forefathers had been promised, but also that their own parents had been too afraid to actually take a hold of, to step into. And so we're going to take a look at that story because it is not unlike the story that we are currently in our circumstances. So we want to look at the challenges, the difficulties, the circumstances that they were in and discover who God is and who we're called to be, how he leads and provides for his people. So our passage today is Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 to 9. So if you have a Bible or if you have a phone or whatever, I want you to just open your Bibles right now, and you can look it up, Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 to 9. Joshua, if you don't know, is the sixth book of the Bible after Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. And we're going to look at the first chapter in just the first 9 verses. So if you found that, I invite you wherever you are, just read out loud with me as we go. I'm going to be reading from the NIV, the New International Version. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all these people, get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I am about to give them to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Your territory will extend from the desert of Lebanon and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country to the great sea on the west. No one will be able to stand up against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their forefathers to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. So Moses is dead. Moses is dead. The leader that God had sent, you know, the one to whom the burning bush had appeared, God had sent him to bring the people out of Egypt, and he had accomplished that. This leader who had taken the people out of under the Pharaoh's iron fist, out of slavery, led them across the Red Sea to worship God at Mount Sinai, through whom the law had been given from God to his people, that leader is dead. That's verse 1. And Joshua, not me, the one in the scripture, he had the task, maybe some would say the impossible task, of following after Moses as the leader of the Israelites. It's a pretty tough act to follow. And it's understandable if he might have felt overwhelmed, maybe fearful, maybe discouraged, maybe inadequate, maybe about how we feel to handle the coronavirus situation with all the uncertainty. Joshua was given this command from the Lord to take you, or to take all these people into the land that I'm going to give them. You're going to lead them, Joshua. Their territory is going to be huge. From the river to the sea, from the desert to Lebanon. You're going to do it, Joshua. It felt huge, I'm sure. And the thing is, he didn't really have any clear instructions. There were instructions around how to do it, but the specifics of, like, what are you going to do? What is your military strategy? How are you going to beat the guys? He didn't have any of those instructions. It was just like, go in and you follow me. His main instruction was obedience. And again, like we are in this situation, we don't really have any instructions. Abel, who's over here, they had to like design a system to like take in a bunch of people's applications, a new system, and they had to design it in how many days? In 2 weeks, they had to design this system to take in a whole bunch of applications for like rental support or whatever it was. And there aren't any instructions. I mean, they had structure and they had an idea, but they had to figure it out together. And a lot of us might be feeling that. We have to figure out, for parents, it's like, how do I do schooling at home with my kids and also work from home? You know, for people who are out of a job, you got to figure out how to apply. Do I apply? How do I apply for, you know, EI or for the CERB or whatever it is? We're trying to figure these things out. We don't have instructions or really a clear sense of how to do it. There are sort of guidelines and stuff. But we got to go through and we got to figure it out and problem solve. But Joshua's main instruction from God was to obey him. Was to obey him. And so he had to obey God into the unknown. And that's what our theme is today. Next slide. So Joshua faces the unknown. He's had the opportunity to follow Moses. He was Moses' assistant for probably the 40 years and maybe a bit before that, that they wandered the desert. Joshua and Caleb were the only two who were there at the very beginning of, you know, trying to enter the promised land when they backed off. They were the two spies who went in and said, no, we can do it. And everybody said, no, we can't. And the people decided they couldn't. And that's why they had to wander for 40 years. And so Joshua and Caleb, they're the only ones left. And Joshua has been assigned the task of leading the people after Moses. And he's facing the unknown. They're standing. I picked a picture of a river, just sort of imagining. They're standing at the river's edge. They're on one side. And they're looking across the river. And they got to get across the river. And once they're there, they don't know exactly where they're going. They got to spy out the land. They got to figure out where all the cities are. And they got to capture that land that God has promised them. Just imagine his head racing, facing the unknown. Facing the unknown. Right now, we're getting a lot of instructions from, you know, our dear friend Bonnie, Dr. Bonnie Henry, and the minister Dix, on how we're supposed to behave, right? On how life is supposed to be. Social distancing, don't go out if it's not necessary, you know, don't have play dates for your kids, or don't go hang out with your friends. I mean, you know all these things. We don't really know how long it's going to last. We don't know how things will shift or change, but we have these instructions. They guide us for the time being. They lead us forward. But we got to figure out the details in our own lives. We got to figure our details as a community. What does that look like for us? How do we follow these instructions? And maybe for some of us, we're already starting to get tired with these instructions, you know? Or we're getting tired with the consequences of them. Maybe some of you watching right now are feeling a lot of screen fatigue, right? Video call fatigue. We're working from home, so we're spending a lot of time in front of our screens, more maybe than we used to, or at least more through calls and stuff like that. You might be starting to feel a bit burnt out and realizing how important it is for us to actually have human interaction, person-to-person interaction. The temptation might be to try to escape in the midst of everything, to escape into gamings, into shows and movies, and to hide away from the difficulty, to try to cover up those feelings. But God offers us a different way forward. God calls Joshua and the people to cross the Jordan River, to step into the unknown, to face it, and to work through the struggle of that, to confront it, not to avoid it, not to hide from it, not to escape from it, but rather to face it full on, to take it on. And God gives us each other to do that. We're not alone in this. And he actually gives us himself. God promises, he says, I am about to give this land to the people, to them. And he says, as I was with Moses, so I will be with you. God says that to you and I. Do you hear him saying that? As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. That's God's promise if we follow after him and obey him. Now, of course, if Joshua had turned around and said, you know what? This is a bit too much for me. I prefer to wander the desert for another 40 years, and then I'll die and leave it off for my successor. I don't think it would have been the same thing. But God says, if you obey me, if you're willing to face and enter into the unknown, if you're willing to struggle and work through this, the difficulty of life as it is right now, I will be with you. I will be with you. God promises Joshua that he will lead the people to victory. Do you believe that you can have a victorious life right now? It might feel like you're defeated. You know, I mean, I enjoy wearing sweatpants all the time, so this is no different for me. But some of you are like, oh, I need to wear some jeans. I'm always in sweatpants. You know, go ahead, wear some jeans at home. That's okay. Feel good. Or a suit. If you're Iggy, maybe you want to wear a suit. I am definitely sweatpants and sweatshirt all the time. If I could come to work like that, I would definitely do that. But, you know, for your sake, I'm not doing it. Huh? Formal Fridays. Yeah, sure. Formal Fridays at home. But the point is, God gives us his presence, which empowers us to be victorious over whatever it is that we're facing, whatever struggle it is that we have. Just as he promised Joshua and the Israelites that he would lead them to victory, he promises that to us, that he will be with us if we follow after him. What is the promised land for us? What is the promised land for us? What is God's promises for us? God promises to be with us, to strengthen us, to empower us. What does it look like? I've heard some really encouraging stories recently of people seeking to bless others, getting groceries, having social distancing conversations, giving cards or encouraging messages, bringing posters to people's house, going and serving the poor in a safe way, but just sort of bringing resources to those who are needy. You and your family can take this opportunity to ask Jesus how you could be a blessing, to extend the promises that God gives you to others. If God empowers you, then through you, God can empower others. God can embolden others. God can say, be strong and courageous to you, be strong and very courageous, and you in turn can pass that on to others. Are you feeling weak? Are you feeling afraid and discouraged? Me too. But I want you to hear God's words as he spoke them to Joshua in Scripture, as he speaks to me, Joshua, as he speaks to you. Be strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. Believe in these promises that I give you of my presence, that I will lead you to victory. Believe in me. Be strong and courageous. Don't let go. Don't let go. Maybe some of us have started to let go, you know, and we're struggling with how we feel. Maybe some of us have started to let go and we're just like, I'm just going to eat chips all the time. I was dieting through Lent, but now chips, chips, chips. God says to you, be strong and courageous. It's weird doing school right now. It's weird doing work right now. Be strong and courageous. Press in with him. Ask him to help you. Ask him to change your attitude. If you're feeling discouraged, ask him, God, I want to be encouraged today. God, give me motivation today. I want to be strong and courageous because God promises to be with you. He will never leave you or forsake you. That's what he says. That's what he says. Be strong and courageous. He says it three times. When you say something, when you see something in Scripture three times in a quick succession, that's a super like exclamation mark, all caps kind of situation. God is declaring this into our beings just as he declared it over Joshua. Be strong and courageous. And do you know what the key to that is? To be strong and courageous. It's not about you. The key is going to God. In verse 7 and 8, the Lord says to Joshua, be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. When you obey God, you will be successful wherever you go. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. The key is being filled with God's presence. The key is allowing God's word to breathe life into us. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. In my family, we wake up quite early and we start our morning. We like to start our morning with time with Abba, to be in God's word, so that God's word informs the rest of our day. And I find when I skip time with Abba, if I miss it in a morning and I forget to read the scripture and copy it out, then I'm missing God's voice. I'm not getting those echoes where he brings back verses that I read. Today, we were reading about Zacchaeus. And Jesus says, come, I want to eat at your house today, to Zacchaeus. And so God has been saying to me, come, enter in. I want to party with you. And so when I'm feeling discouraged, Jesus is like, hey, come, don't forget, I'm with you. I want to enjoy life with you. Come with me. And that's what God's word can do when we spend time. And I'm not saying you have to read tons and tons and tons. Maybe just read the psalm. But allow God's word to be in your heart. Plant that seed at the very beginning so it could sprout later on. So that his words might be on your lips, in your mind throughout the day. So that when you're feeling discouraged, you can cry out with those words of the psalm. Sometimes he's like, God, where are you? And you can say, God, where are you? I know that the psalm lets me say that to you, God. But I will trust in you. I will have faith in you. You know, even Jesus himself often went off early in the morning to spend time with the Father, soaking in the Father's words so that he would be ready for that day. Even Jesus himself had to be strengthened by the Father. We recently just passed Easter, but before that was Good Friday. On the night before Maundy Thursday, we think about that overnight vigil where Jesus says to his disciples, could you not stay up for an hour or two to pray with me? Because he was praying, he was calling out to the Father. Lord, if you would, Father, if you would take this away from me, but not my will, but yours be done. Jesus was strengthened by spending time soaking in the Father's love and the Father's words. When we look at these examples, we can be encouraged that God gives us that strength. When he says, be strong and courageous, he's not saying, hey, Abel, hey, Iggy, hey, Vance, you got to get that strength in yourself. You got to buckle up, tighten your muscles, and go for it. You got to grit your teeth, and you got to figure it out. That's what our life tells us. That's what our society tells us. That's what our culture says. You know, pull yourself up by your bootstraps kind of thing. But no, God says, be strong and courageous because I am the one who is going to empower you. I will give you the words and the life. Be strong and courageous, even when you face the unknown, the uncertain, what is going to happen, even when you're afraid of what is going on. Next slide. This week, I want to give you three suggestions that you can do at home. And actually, without talking about this, Pastor Iggy already did the first one. The first suggestion is this. Just make a sign for yourself that says, be strong and courageous. Iggy, do you want to grab your sign to show everybody?
Can you see it?
Yeah. All right, so he made a be strong and courageous sign. Okay, we can put that down. But you don't have to, it doesn't have to be as big as that. You know, it could be hand-drawn, handwritten, whatever, printed out. It's up to you. But I would like for you to put up, be strong and courageous. God says this to you. It's his promise to you that he will do this. Put it up somewhere in your house. Put it up somewhere where you'll see it regularly. On your fridge door, on the window, on a wall that you walk by regularly. Put it up somewhere where you can regularly see God's command, but also encouragement to you. Be strong and courageous. The second thing is this. Create a special time to be with God, preferably in the morning. As you eat breakfast is great. Before, fine, no problem. But give God that first part of your day a special time to be with him. Soak in his presence. Just say, hey, God, I'm going to give you this day. And just say that every day. It's okay to repeat the same prayers. God, I love you. I want to give you this day. Would you be with me? Would you speak to me? And then read some of God's word. Allow him to speak to you through his word and carry that with you through the day. But create a special time. Create a special time. Maybe you want to, you know, have a nice little plant in front of you just to bring a bit of life as a way of creating a space. It's just my dining table. Well, put a plant there. Make it different for that moment at least. So that's the second thing. Create a special time to be with God. And the third thing is, don't just keep it for yourself. Ask God to show you the faces of people who you can bless. Maybe it's one or two or three people, or maybe it's more. Maybe it's relatives. Maybe it's friends. Maybe it's classmates. Maybe it's workplace, you know, colleagues, bosses, whatever. Ask God. Pray and ask God to show you three people that you can bless, to send an encouraging text to call up and say, hey, I was just praying and God showed me your face and I was thinking about you and I just wanted to ask, hey, how are you doing? You know, to send some cookies over or to socially distant visit, you know, or to whatever it is. Send a meme to them. Just be a blessing. Ask God to show you how you can take the blessing that he gives you, the promises that he gives you, and extend it to others. Right? We want to be planted for relationship. God plants us for relationship. Even when we face the unknown, let's press in. And let's not just say, oh, woe is me. But let's say, actually, God has given me good things, and I want to bless other people with that. Let's pray. God, would you empower us by your Holy Spirit to change our attitudes, to be transformed in the ways that we are thinking, and to live life for you. God, would you help us to be strong and courageous? God, we can't do it on our own. We've tried. It's hard. We need your help. Holy Spirit, would you empower us to be strong and courageous? And God, would you show us who we can bless? Who are the people around us that we can encourage and bless and simply pray for? Holy Spirit, come. Do this in our hearts, we pray. Amen. Just for your lunchtime or going into the day or whatever, we do have a big question. Did I put a big question in? Nope, there's no big question in the slides. My big question is this. We'll just talk about it. How are you encouraged by God's words, be strong and courageous? And in what areas of your life do you really need it right now? You know, is it in terms of friendship? Is it in terms of discipline? Is it in terms of family? Is it in terms of work or thinking about the future? How do you want God to encourage you with his words, be strong and courageous?
So I was kind of prompted by the Spirit when you were speaking, Josh, just to do something we had not even talked about, but it just came to me. So sometimes we hear, be strong and courageous. We're told it, but we don't really believe it. Or we believe it, but we really need to declare it into ourselves. You know, speaking is a prophetic act. So I think we're going to try a little tag team here, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to speak into his being that you are strong and courageous. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to say, Joshua, you are strong and courageous.
Oh.
And he's going to say, amen. I am strong and courageous.
Okay.
You know, Zoe always asks me, kids ask me, why do we say amen all the time? Because amen is an agreement. Mm. Is Jesus saying something? You say, yes, I agree with it. So I'll do that to you once and you do that to me. We'll do it back and forth. Okay. If you're at home, we can do it to each other too. Okay. All right? I'm going to look at you in the eye and say, Joshua, you are strong and courageous. Ooh,
yes, amen. I am strong and courageous. Iggy, you are strong and courageous.
Amen. I am strong and courageous. Amen. Hey, one and one more. God will go with you, Joshua, wherever you go.
Okay. Amen. God will go with me wherever I go.
Amen.
Iggy, God will go with you wherever you go.
Amen. God will go with me wherever I go.
Amen.
Amen. So you declare that amongst yourselves with your families. God will go with you wherever you go. Ooh. I have shivers right now because God is with us. Amen. All right, let's declare it. Let's sing, Whom Shall I Fear? No one but the Lord.
You hear me when I call. You are my morning song. Though darkness fills the night, it cannot hide the light.
whom shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath my feet. You are my sword and shield. Though trouble linger still, shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. My strength is in your name, for you alone can save. You will deliver me. Yours is the victory. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. And nothing formed against me shall stand. You hold the whole world in your hand. Holding on to your promises. You are faithful. You are faithful. And nothing formed against me shall stand. You hold the whole world in your hand. I'm holding on your promises. You are faithful. You are faithful. You are faithful. I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The God of angel armies is always by my side.
So church, may we be people who are strong and courageous. May we be strengthened in our spirits by the Holy Spirit to be a blessing to our families, to our friends, to our coworkers, classmates, and to our neighbors. Amen.
Amen.
Well, glad everybody could join us this week. If you are able, we would love to have you hang out for our family table after this. And yeah, bless you into this week.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.